Hey there, viewers. Your body sometimes has patience for sugary treats, but when you eat too much, it's poison for you. Not only will sugar ruin your teeth, but also your liver. The effects of sugar set in fairly slow. You want to curb your habit before it's too late. In today's video, we'll be discussing why sugar gives you a fatty liver. What foods do I try to avoid? What foods can save me from this condition? We're talking all of that and more. Why can't people let go of sugar? Who doesn't love sweets? The act of eating out of an ice cream tub while watching Netflix is like heaven. But when you read about what sugar does to your body, you'll think differently. Sugar ranks high among the most addictive substances in the world. Your brain reacts to sugar the same way it reacts to certain drugs. It releases a feel-good hormone called dopamine from your brain. The brain signals the body to consume more sugar in order to release more dopamine. This satisfying process of rewarding the body becomes a habit. Over time, simple sugars become an addiction. Your tolerance level also increases gradually. Instead of putting just one sugar cube in your tea or coffee, you feel like putting two, or maybe three. Sweets as simple as a bar of chocolate have the potential to make you obese. Obesity is the mother of all diseases. It leads to heart issues, diabetes, cancer, liver dysfunction, high blood pressure, metabolic syndrome, etc. Do you have a sweet tooth? Do you have sugared tea or coffee on a daily basis? Share your preferences with the Bestie community in the comments below. So, what exactly does the liver do? Your liver is the second largest organ in the body, the first being the skin. It weighs a little over a pound and performs 500 different functions at the same time. Now, it may be only the size of a football, but it's great at multitasking. Your liver is located just under your ribs on the right-hand side. It helps to get the maximum amount of nutrients out of your food and holds up to 13% of your blood supply. Its primary job is filtering the blood from two places. One vein brings the blood from the heart, located above the liver. The other vein brings the blood from the intestines, below the liver. Looking for the answers on all the latest health and wellness news? Hit the subscribe button and join our millions of followers. Stay up to date on all of our great Bestie content. To put it bluntly, without your liver, you would die. The hepatic portal vein is responsible for carrying blood from the intestine to the liver. This blood is rich in carbohydrates, fats, and essential vitamins. It gets its nutrients from the food which you consume. They're broken down further by primary units of the liver called lobules. Lobules also provide oxygen required for the liver to work. The content in the blood is processed differently. So that means whatever food, medicines, alcohol, or toxic substances you consume go through the liver once digested. The liver detoxifies your body, which are of no nutritive value are detected by the liver and converted into body-friendly substances. If this can't happen, it decides to send it to the kidneys and intestines and throw it away from the body in the form of urine or stool. When the liver breaks down carbohydrates, it converts them into sugars. These sugars are then flown back into the bloodstream and provide you instant energy. The liver assesses the situation and sends only the required amount of sugar into the bloodstream. Excess sugars are then stored for emergencies. To put it simply, the liver acts as a type of storage unit. Pretty crazy, huh? Before we move ahead, here's another video you might like. Watch and learn more about the 7 signs of magnesium deficiency. The liver makes plasma protein, an absolute essential to stop the bleeding after wounds and cuts. Blood plasma is also necessary for transferring fats. It's a great organ that converts cholesterol to hormones. Vitamin D is the only vitamin synthesized in the body, and its production takes place in the liver. Another important function is the production of bile. The waste products that are not sent to the kidneys for excretion are converted into gunk by the cells of the liver. If you suffer from acidity on an empty stomach in the morning, you're likely to have bouts of vomiting containing bile. This is a greenish-yellow, bitter-tasting liquid. But the liver doesn't throw away its bile. It pushes the bile into a balloon-like organ called a gallbladder, sitting right behind the liver. This part-time bile container trickles the bile down into the intestine to digest fats. It also kills microorganisms and maintains pH level of stomach acids. Your liver has been producing blood since before you were born, basically right from the fetal stage. It holds iron necessary for carrying oxygen into our bodies. The liver has a miraculous ability to regenerate itself. This is what helps you during liver transplants. What is fatty liver? How is sugar responsible for it? Did you know that consuming simple sugars like glucose and fructose are a major cause of fat synthesis in the liver? They're even worse than dietary fat. Sugar contains extremely simple forms of carbs, which are broken down very quickly by the liver. Means if we take an equal amount of sugar and fiber, more fat cells will be formed by sugar than fiber. Consuming excessive sugar stimulates the fat-synthesizing machinery of the liver by double speed. Fatty liver increases your chance of developing type 2 diabetes. It also alters your metabolism in a bad way. Fatty liver changes the way the liver functions. It decreases the efficiency of the liver and leads to many different harmful effects. You're not going to have the long life you've always wanted. Fatty liver happens when there's a buildup of fat in your liver. When there's too much fat in your liver, it causes inflammation. This will eventually lead to scarring. Let's talk about non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, NAFLD. This is when there are too many triglycerides in the liver for someone who isn't drinking booze. So the next time you consume more sugar than what is needed by your body, think twice. You might be poisoning your liver. Here's what you need to do with a fatty liver. The first thing you need to do is change your diet. You should also start exercising on a regular basis. In really severe cases, you need to talk to a doctor. A simple change, like consuming complex carbs over simple carbs, is key. Increasing fiber content and protein in your foods can make you feel full a lot quicker. Anti-inflammatory foods also heal the liver faster. These foods include garlic and omega-3 fatty acids. These are present in sardines, walnuts, flax seeds, coffee, broccoli, green tea, walnuts, and whey protein. The Mediterranean diet has also been found to cure fatty liver. Here's a few things you don't do. Things you should absolutely stay away from are soda, energy drinks, desserts, chocolates, candy, and packed foods. Sugar in other forms like fructose or corn syrup should also be avoided. Alcohol can cause liver cirrhosis and other long-term effects on the body. The leading cause of fatty liver other than sugar is alcohol. Refined foods that contain simple carbs like white bread, rice, and pasta are again a big no-no. Multigrain bread and legumes are a great alternative. Fried and salty foods also increase fat storage in the body. This leads to obesity, which causes fatty liver disease. Red meats like beef and pork have high amounts of saturated fat. Choose lean foods like fish and tofu instead. Carbs certainly help reduce symptoms of fatty liver. But getting on a low-carb diet can be challenging, especially if you don't know which foods to eat. There are several foods low in calories thanks to their low-carb count. Here's what you need to know. Check out 20 low-carb foods you need to eat. Or how about 38 delicious foods that contain almost zero calories? Go ahead and click one, or better yet, watch both, and learn more about how to become healthier. Do you struggle with eating sugar-free food? Let us know in the comments below.